excited to see your faces. They've been so excited today as we've talked about the band concert. And for Beginning Band, it's their very first one ever. So that's pretty exciting. Students, we know that you have worked so hard and practiced many hours. Yes, practiced many hours to come for this day, and I am very delighted to hear. Thank you to the band directors, Mrs. Clements and Mrs. Bowen, for directing these bands and for putting in their own many, many hours, instructing and caring. Yes. And thank you to the parents for listening and for your many, many hours of supporting your student and all of us here at Coram Deo as well. We are recording this concert tonight in order to make sure that everyone enjoys the concert. We ask that if you have fussy little ones, that you just take them outside for a little jaunt around the hallways until they calm down so that we can all enjoy the concert together. Now we're going to talk briefly about some safety protocols and have a moment of prayer. But before we do, I would like to introduce the Dean of Schools, Mr. Toby Oakes, to come and join me. Mr. Oakes is going to help me in these lovely and somewhat boring, conversations about safety regulations here at our school. So, should there be an emergency that requires evacuation, the audience needs to leave by the nearest exit signs. Please make your way to the student parking lot. Do not come to stage to retrieve your student. The band directors will see to the student's safety using the back exits. Families will be reunited outside in the student parking lot. We would like to ask that you please silence all handheld devices. This will avoid awkward stares if it happens to go off. Thank you for silencing your phone. Yeah, okay, we got it. Thank you. Yes, Mr. Oakes. We hope you can sit back now and relax and enjoy the beautiful music that these students have to offer. Mr. Oakes will now open us in prayer.
And I will use words this time. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for the hard work of the students, for Mrs. Bowen, for Mrs. Clements, for all the private instructors. We pray that tonight would be just a great celebration of all that you have done, the creative gifts and the work and the discipline you've given these students and these families. So Lord, we do sit back and we look forward to enjoy this concert and pray that you'd be glorified in it. And we pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll sit back, relax, and enjoy the concert.
So thank you so much for coming again tonight. This year has really been a year like none other, and how many of you feel like it's just flown by? I know we have. So more than ever this year, we try to make our classroom environment just one of joy, and our focus has been on devotions. In our symphonic band, as well as our intermediate band, we have been going through a book by Tim Keller, and it's called The Songs of Jesus. It's a daily devotional book over the book of Psalms. And these weekly devotions focus not only on just talking through what it's like to live as a middle school student or a person in the world, but specifically they spoke to our heart a lot about what it's like to live through this current pandemic that we've been going through. And so this band community has been so healing, and it's been so wonderful to go through these devotions together and focus on the goodness of God. And during this season, we have really needed each other, and that being said, we've really enjoyed our community as a band. The Psalms often refer to instruments in worship and the importance of that aspect of the musical ensemble. And so at this time, we 100% dedicate this performance, this entire evening of music, to the Lord, our Creator. And that being said, now I'm gonna hand off to Tessa, and she's gonna share a psalm.
Psalm 150 reads, "Praise the Lord. Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and the lyre. Praise him with the timbrel and dancing. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of the cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord."
So how about those resounding cymbals? Mr. Noah over there. All right, before we play our next piece, I do want to have our beginning band students stand up. So can you do that right now, beginning band students, stand up? Stay standing for a second. So I wanted them to stand now because they're going to play one more piece with the intermediate band, and then we'll dismiss them. But I wanted to just say this about these students. First of all, less than a year ago, they couldn't even like hold the instrument the right way, or you know, even get a sound out of the instrument, and here they are playing this amazing music. So I'm just so very proud of these guys. Aren't they amazing? So I also would like to say, first period Friday mornings, I get to see these students, and they are my favorite. They just are so much fun. We have a great time together. We do a lot of laughing. We have fun with devotionals, and I have a question for Isaac. So Isaac is wearing a tie tonight. He's over here playing the trumpet. And he told me in the last beginning band class, he says, if I'm wearing a tie, then my mom caught me
and put it on me tonight. Like he had to run to catch me to put that tie on. So good job, Mrs. Wren. There she is. So everybody just looks so good. I'm just real proud of you guys. You can go ahead and have a seat now. So we are going to do another piece with Beginning Band. It's called Furiant. And a furiant is a rapid bohemian dance in alternating 2-4 and 3-4 time with frequently shifting accents. So if you know what I mean when I talk about 2-4 and 3-4, those are time signatures. Listen for that shift in the time, and we hope that you enjoy Furiant. Transition while the beginners exit the stage. So, Mrs. Clements and I have so enjoyed working with our Logic School bands at Collin County and Flower Mound, and it's been a lot of fun just putting the bands together and making this big, awesome, giant sound. And here's my reminder about just being together, coming together to the band parents and students, and that is that we have a band camp coming up May 17th through the 20th. Is that right, Ms. Clements? And so we hope that every one of these students is able to take part in that because when we can be together, the friendships get better, bigger, and greater. So we want you to, your student, to be a part of that camp. And we have awesome student helpers like Owen Girth helping us out with camp. A lot of times we have the Symphonic Band, a pretty big group from the Symphonic Band, helping out with camp. So it's just a great mentorship opportunity for those students as well. So, all right, Ms. Clements.
So yes, again, just got so used to wearing it, I forget I have it on. We do love having both campuses together at band camp. It's just a wonderful opportunity for us to make friends across the campuses and just really make music together. Now, before we play our next piece, we want to recognize the students on this stage that auditioned and made the All-Region Honor Band, or made First Alternate. So students, can you please stand when I call your name, and parents, can you hold your applause till the end? On flute, we have Caden Ellis-Smith. On clarinet, we have Seth Bell and Nathan Antonacci. On alto saxophone, we have Joseph Bell and Jason Rakowski. Trumpet players, Bethany Croft, and Jenna Mullins, who I would like to note has been a virtual student all year long, but took lessons and still made the band. On French horn, we have Joseph Younger, Scott Avenshine, and Levi Robertson. Side note, Levi made first chair. On trombone, we have Luke Saladin and Jonathan Papila. Papila's another first chair. On euphonium, Jack Revering and another first chair, Caleb Schau. And then tuba, we had Braden Axford and Cal Catino. Cal is also a first chair winner. And then in the percussion section, we have Gabe Girth, Jack Hamm, and Lucas Smith. And then finally, we want to recognize one student who auditioned and made the TPSMEA High School All-Region Honor Band, and that young lady is Katie Duhan. So can you join me in giving a round of applause to these students? And now before we play our next piece, one of our student helpers, Owen Girth here, is going to share one of our devotions from Psalm 24.
Hello. Oh, should probably raise this one a little bit. There we go. Hello, my name is Owen Girth. I'm the symphonic band captain at Flower Mound, and I'm also the student helper for the intermediate band. And before we play our last piece, second to last piece, I want to share with you just one more devotion, like Ms. Clement said, from Psalm 24, verses 1 through 6. The earth is the Lord and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it on the seas and established it on the waters. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not trust in an idol or swear by a false god. They will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from God their Savior. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek your face, God of Jacob. Everything we have in this life is God's. Every accomplishment, every achievement, every goal attained is by his grace alone. What do we have that we did not receive? Now, this is not to belittle earthly accomplishments. Those things still matter. All those students we just talked about who made All-Region Band, they can and they should still be proud of that. But everything must have its place. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? David asks. He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not trust in an idol or swear by a false god. So let us celebrate our accomplishments tonight, but not make idols out of them. Let us recognize the thing for its worth. But more than that, let us remember that it is by God's grace and his grace alone that we do everything. Please enjoy our next piece, Sparks.
Thank you.
time, I would like to recognize a few students. First of all, we want to recognize Lauren Joseph as the beginning band helper at Flower Mound. Is she out?
She is. Over there. Wait, hey.
Thank you. And I would like to recognize my Collin County Intermediate Band assistants. You guys can just wave. Avery Mizell, Caden Ellis-Smith, and Luke Saladin. Mrs. Bowen would like to recognize her Flower Mound Intermediate Band assistants, and they are Kirsten Brown. They're entering the stage. Owen Girth and Tessa Linebarger. And we appreciate these students so much because every week there are 1,000 things to do behind the scenes. And we are so very appreciative of our symphonic band students who spend their quote unquote free time helping us out. And would you like to know why there's a constant stream of people coming in and off the stage? Sure you would. You probably want to know. It's on purpose. These are some of our symphonic band students who are joining us for our last piece. And we are so very proud of all of these students. They have all, as individuals, accomplished so much this year. And every one of these students worked up and performed a solo in front of their classmates. I can tell you, as a musician, since I was their age, the scariest thing is playing in front of your friends. But they did it, and they did a beautiful job. Every year, that's my favorite time of year. Beginning band students as well, yes. Many of them auditioned for All Region Band, and more importantly, we grew together as a family in Christ, and we grew together in our love for one another. So parents of beginning, intermediate, and symphonic band, now we say we appreciate you and your dedication to our program and your students' success. And we know you're counting all the times that you drive to and from private lessons or you host private lessons at your house when you drive to and from the Flower Mound campus and everything else that you do in between. So we want to now, students, we're going to clap for our parents. And we also want to say that our private lesson teachers are simply amazing, and without them, we just would not have the program that we have, so we thank them so much as well. And finally, we thank our administrators. Where are our administrators? Can we make them wave? There's one. They're out taking care of things for us, but there's Mrs. Williams. We thank you for loving us, supporting us, and just for loving the fine arts. And now, student helpers that have entered the stage, can you wave? Can we clap for them? They're going to be amazing. Are you ready for me to stop talking? Oh, I am. So this is the intermediate band playing their last piece for you. And we thought that you guys would really enjoy this experience with some of our experienced jazz players from the symphonic band who have stepped up to the stage. So please enjoy our last piece. It's a jazz standard, and it's called In the Mood. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much. That was amazing. Thank you, students, and thank you, band directors, as well, for that wonderful, joyful performance. I'm so proud of you all. I want to give just a few announcements. Before I do, you might wonder why I'm wearing mini ears. Well, that's a good question. Thank you for asking. Our Rhetoric School band, Symphonic Band, will be going to Disney World next school year, and that includes our eighth graders, current eighth graders, going into ninth grade next year. So in order to support that endeavor, we have wonderful refreshments outside of the Lyceum building, and all donations will go towards that trip. In addition, there will also be a collection basket or jar there that will also, you can just empty your wallet. Just go ahead and empty them all out there. Just, you know, you don't need to carry that around anyway. It's not safe. So just put it in there for Disney trip for next year, so our current eighth graders and our Rhetoric School can attend Disney. And they have lots to do there. They're not just going to play, although they will play. That will be fun. But they're going to perform at Disney Springs, and they get to do some workshops there and with some really prestigious people. So it really is a wonderful trip to go on, a great experience, yes. So a few last announcements before I let you go. As she mentioned, band camp is coming up very shortly at the end of May, and you may actually go ahead and already register for that. Just go to your family login and hit the summer button, and you can register tonight for it and get your kids all ready to go. As you know, that we have a very busy schedule. You may be feeling that right about now. We are a busy school. This Thursday, we have our choir concert at 7 o'clock here in the Lyceum. And then next Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, we will have the performance of Cinderella. Our Rhetoric School will be performing that. And then the following week, on April 29th and 30th, the Logic School will be, Theater 1 and Theater 2 will be performing as well. So you'll want to look online and get tickets for that, and look for in our weekly. I know you look at that weekly, right? Those tickets will be, that ticket information will be in the weekly. This performance was recorded tonight, and we have beautiful pictures taken right before, and you'll have the opportunity to purchase those. I think that an email will go out shortly. And we have some forms. Oh, pictures in the back. What a deal. That's great. All right, so in the back you'll have pictures being taken, but then more information will go out on how you can order the CD. So we ask that as you exit tonight, as we wrap up, that you do exit the building. Your students will meet you outside so that you can take part of the concessions, and the band will reset here for the symphonic band that will be starting at 7:30 tonight. So we hope you will join us for that. Oh, okay. She said if you are going to take some individual pictures, so go ahead and meet your student outside and then bring them right back out here to where that big umbrella is, and they'll take the pictures over there. So, yes. And we're going to clear right now? Oh, okay. Sorry. Okay, yes, we're going to exit the building so that we can get ready for Symphonic Band. All right, well, we wish you a very good night and many blessings. Thank you so much for coming.
parking lot. If you don't know which lot the student parking lot is, that's where all the accidents occur right after school. I suggest, and we have said this since the beginning of the year, do not go in that parking lot. We have a reason for that. Are you really turning me off? Seriously? Who's got the sound? Stop it. All right. So sorry. I'm quiet, I'm loud, they never can really control me. Where was I? Back to the student parking lot. Do not come to the stage to retrieve your student or their instruments should there be an emergency. The instruments are okay to not take. I know you don't believe that, but in an emergency, they really are okay to take or leave here. And the band directors will take your students out the back. There are several exits out the back. And they will bring your students to you in that student parking lot. Please do not stand in the road as you might be run over by an arriving emergency vehicle. The band director didn't write that. I just told you that. We are making a digital audio recording of the band concert tonight. So therefore, remove any crying or disruptive children during the performance. Please silence those handheld devices and any other electronic device that you may have on you. We don't need any devices harmonizing with our students' music, which they have been practicing a long time to make sure is in harmony. Disconnect yourself, really, from the world's cares for the next hour and enjoy the evening with your students, these band directors, and their wonderful accomplishments, allowing others around you to enjoy their time as well. To start the evening off, as we always should, please welcome to the stage Mr. Oakes for prayer.
All right, everybody, thank you for coming, and let's pray. Father, thank you for this evening. Thank you for this opportunity just to celebrate the hard work that these students have put in, to celebrate the hard work that Mrs. Bowen and Mrs. Clements and our private instructors have done, and of course, the parents and their support. We also want to celebrate, Lord, just the creativity and the ability you've given these students, that we would enjoy this time and that we would glorify you, Lord, as we think about what you have done to bring these people together, and we thank you for this evening. Pray also for all the technical aspects of this evening, that it would go well. We thank you now, and we pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Enjoy the show.
Before we start the concert today, we would like to dedicate it to the Lord by reading Psalm 150. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and the lyre. Praise him with the timbrel and the dancing. Praise him with the strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So let us also praise the Lord with the 2021 Symphonic Band Concert. Please enjoy.
This year, in all of our bands, we've been going through the devotions in Tim Keller's book, The Songs of Jesus. Each week, one of our band officers leads the band in a devotion from this book. It's allowed us to have special insight on the Psalms so that we can apply them to our lives throughout the week. One of the biggest themes that we've been talking about in Symphonic Bands specifically is the fact that God is still with us in our trials.
As high school students, we were really impacted by the coronavirus. Most of the things that we were really looking forward to last year were canceled, making it really hard to see that God was with us during the time. One of the devotions that we read this year was on Psalm 34, 17 through 22, which says, "The righteous cry out and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers them from them all. He protects all his bones. Not one of them will be broken. Evil will slay the wicked. The foes of the righteous will be condemned. The Lord will rescue his servants. No one who takes refuge in him will be condemned."
Tim Keller writes that these verses say that we can be broken and crushed by life, but these sufferings can bring God's presence near in a way that nothing else can. Going through a pandemic together has brought not only each of us closer, but also us closer to each other. We have had to think about things that we have never had to think about before, such as how we can protect each other best. Although coronavirus seems like a huge struggle, and it seems nearly impossible to see the good in it, David reminds us in the Psalms that the Lord will rescue his servants. Each song that we get to play at this concert reminds us that God rescues us, because otherwise we wouldn't be able to be here performing for each of y'all. Please enjoy our next piece, Lake Dances.
cannot believe that this school year is coming to a close. It feels like a blur to us. Does it feel like a blur to you guys? And so much happens in a school year, any school year, let alone this school year in particular. And this class, these amazing, beautiful students behind me that you see, only meet once a week with a few extra rehearsals before our concert and our contest events in the spring. And that in itself, I think, is worth a hand. My Collin County Symphonic Band meets first period, so it's a little bit different of a culture than Flower Mound afternoon after lunch. So we're a little more subdued in the mornings, or they are anyway. And so oftentimes I'll reflect on my way to work about just all the things that God has done. And a couple of weeks ago I shared with my students that it just hit me so hard that, oh my goodness, this year is almost over. And I think we've all had times where we just weren't sure how it was going to play out. We first were not sure if we would have a Christmas concert, and I get chills thinking about this. Now we're all here and we're having a spring concert, and God is so good. Here, I think the reason that we can put on any kind of concert, aside from the Lord Almighty, is honestly because of tremendous parent support. So if you're a parent here, we just thank you so much for all the time that you've committed to this program. And it is because of your tremendous support and your commitments to ensuring that your student is practicing. And of course, all of this happens in conjunction with our private lesson staff, which is completely amazing. And so we thank you so much for all of that effort. Now I have a fun job of announcing the many accomplishments of students this year. So I'm gonna ask that you please hold your applause until the end of each group. Students have participated in a wide variety of contests this year, although they have looked a little bit differently, and our band students have done amazingly. First of all, we had students make the TPS MEA All Region Band, and students, can you stand on stage if you made the TPS MEA All Region Band? Go ahead, don't be shy. And now you can clap for them. Going to be some up and downs here. Next, I would like those who made the TPS MEA All State Band to stand. Yay. Isn't that amazing? Next, I get to recognize students who made. This is the part I knew I would forget. I'm going to call out their names. These are the students who made, I have a list here, but I still almost forgot. We just got our patches in, and I want to actually call the students' names who made the TPS MEA All-State Band. And Mrs. Bowen will hand you guys a patch. Lauren Joseph. Let's clap for her. Joanna Lee. Tessa Leinbarger, Nolan Marshall, Jenny Covert, Timothy Lee, David Brownen, Brendan Kofink, am I going too fast? Ethan Joseph made first chair. And if he's not embarrassed enough by that, I'm just kidding. That's really not anything to be embarrassed about. But this is his second time to make first chair. Woo! Ethan Kendall made first chair trombone in the jazz band. And then Owen Girth made both the jazz band and the concert band. Yes, so I'm done with that part now. I can put this away. And now, TPSMEA Solo is another event that students went to, and I want to invite students who received a superior performance rating on their solo. If you received a one, please stand on your solo. Amazing. And same goes for TPSMEA Ensemble Contest. Can those of you whose ensemble received a superior performance please stand? You think I'm... Yep. That's almost all of us. I think this is the last time you get to sit and stay. Is she done talking? She's still talking. But I want to say that all of these students that stood to be recognized for making a Division I or a superior rating, we call it, for their solo or their ensemble, also have the honor of advancing to state on those performances. If they did a Class I, they get to go to state. Almost everybody. Is this fun for you guys? Okay, she's wrapping up. These students have worked so hard. We, Mrs. Bowen and I, could not be prouder of their growth, and I know you guys could not be prouder either. Not just their growth in music, but also their growth in character and just their general accomplishments. So congratulations, students. We're so proud of you. So proud. Finally, we are going to hear from one of our state-bound small ensembles. This is the Flower Mound Percussion Ensemble playing a piece that you will love. It's called Rogue Agent.
help it. That was pretty awesome, wasn't it?
Awesome.
So, yay. So I just wanted to, I guess give a shout out to Mr. Johnny Harmon, because he's the one that really, our percussion instructor that worked with these students and got them to this point of excellence. So I know that he is watching online, live stream. So thank you, Johnny Harmon. We appreciate that. Thank you, thank you.
So, good evening. My name is Owen Girth, and I'm the captain of the Flower Mound Symphonic Band. And thank you. Before we play our next piece, I just want to share with you one more devotion that we that was inspired by Tim Keller's book that we did this year. This one's from Psalm 100. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness endures through all generations. This is why we are here tonight. We are not here to praise ourselves, to applaud the gift and not the giver. We are God's people, so let us rejoice accordingly and come before him tonight with a joyful song. In everything we play, in everything we do, may he have preeminence, for he is good, and his love endures forever. Our next piece tonight is the senior piece, which means it's the fun piece. I'm just kidding. We enjoy all of our songs equally. I'm just kidding. Okay. This year's senior piece was chosen by the band seniors, the class of 2021, and the piece we chose was a medley taken from the 2016 musical La La Land. So without further ado, please enjoy La La Land.
Thank you.
one was here. There we go. All right. So after we play this next piece, we're going to be honoring our seniors. And you all are invited to stay. However, if you have young families and you need to go, there'll be a transition time for you to make a quick exit. Before we play our final piece, we do have a few folks that we need to thank. Let me put this baton down. Private lesson teachers. We definitely could not make this program work without you. You are crucial to our success. Thank you for partnering. I know a lot of you are watching live stream, so thank you for being a part of our lives. We would like to recognize a couple of students who faithfully all year set up our band classroom, including setting up chairs, stands, and percussion equipment every Thursday. And that would be David Brownen and Ethan Kendall. Can you please stand? We have a gift for you. So for me, this is a standing ovation. That's so huge. Some of you may or may not realize that our classroom, I mean, it's a classroom with tables and chairs set up, and all our percussion is put in a closet. All of our percussion instruments and big instruments are put in a closet every week, Monday through Thursday, and then we have to pull everything out Thursday afternoon and set up a band classroom. So it's just huge, and I obviously could not do that every Thursday, so I'm really dependent on those guys every week to do that for me. So thank you, thank you. Big shout out to Mr. Tyson Guthrie for setting up and running our sound. Thank you, Mr. Guthrie. Mrs. Jerry Colvin for running our lights. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And big thank you to Joe Pyatt, Kevin Lewis, and Shane Clardy for their help with set up all these tarps. This is a gym. You may or may not know, this is gym with a stage. But we actually turn it into an auditorium. And Mr. Pyatt, Mr. Lewis, and Shane, they do that for us by putting down these tarps and putting out chairs. So thank you to them. Thank you to Elizabeth and David Rogers and John Duhon for live stream help. Thank you very much for that. Thank you, thank you. And thank you to those who supported the band through band boosters and donations. I also would like to recognize my wonderful band booster team, Michelle Brown, Bill and Laura Rauhauser, Kim Brownen, Lisa Joseph, Allison Saladin, and Tanya Henderson. And back up to Kim Brownen. This is her final concert, and I might quit today. I mean, this may be my last day, I don't know, because she and her husband Mike have been such an amazing support to me. They have driven that band trailer out to football games year after year, and oh my goodness, I'm going to cry about them not coming back. I'll cry for my seniors, but I may cry more for them, I don't know. I just so appreciate them. So thank you to them, Allison Saladin over at Collin County, Tanya Henderson, who helped set up the band dinner party, which was pretty fantastic. So thank you for doing that. They keep our band organized and funded and do all this behind the scenes preparations for concerts, planning trips. And more than anything, they keep me encouraged. And I just so, so appreciate them. So can you stand, those people? We want to clap for you. Stand up, our band booster people. Yay. Thank you. Okay, and then we'd like to thank our administrators that encourage us and support us in so many ways. Our president, Dr. Marshall, are you here? You should be, because your son's playing the bassoon and percussion. Where's Dr. Marshall?
He's in Denver.
Oh, he's not. Okay, so he's probably watching live stream. Okay, but the mom is here. Hey, there we go. And Dr. Armstrong, Mrs. Dwyer, and our other principals, Mrs. Williams and Mrs. Garland, we just so appreciate all you do to support the CDA Fine Arts communities here at our schools. That's just so important, and that is not always the case, especially at private schools. So thank you, thank you. Our final piece is titled Joy Revisited. I love this title because we are coming out of a difficult year. and starting to see glimmers of hope. It's like taking certain things for granted, like the heater when we were in the midst of our Texas snowmageddon, right? When the electricity came back on, we had a new appreciation for electricity. The same can be said about joy. We take it for granted until hard times like COVID hit us. I feel like we are really revisiting joy and hope. It's fresh and it feels new. Psalms 35, verse 5 says, "For his anger is but for a moment, his favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may last for the night, but a shout of joy comes in the morning." Please enjoy our final piece, Joy Revisited.
Thank you.
at this time. I'm going to have the seniors go ahead and come on up. I'm going to have you over here. You can start the line.
Can I say something? Okay. Before we go, can we just have one round of applause for Mrs. Bone and Mrs. Clements and for all the work they did? So I lied. I need the mic for just a little bit more than a second. Mrs. Bowen and Mrs. Clements have put so much work into this year, trying to give us a normal band season in the midst of what is probably the weirdest year in CDA history. So just to thank them and all the work that they do, we have a couple gifts for them that we want to give to them. But before we do that, I just want to say a quick word about Mrs. Bowen, and then our Collin County captain, Audrey Saladin, is going to do the same about Mrs. Clements. Mrs. Bowen has been my band director for 7 years, since the time that I was a little snotty-nosed sixth grader to the long-haired mess that you see before you today. I think I speak for the entire Flowerman band when I say that I owe a great deal of my development, both as a musician and as a person, to Mrs. Bowen. She is genuinely one of the sweetest and most gracious people I've ever met, and I count myself as incredibly blessed to have had her as my band director. She cares for all of us as people, not just as instruments in her band. She cares about our sports games and our schoolwork, about whether we have friends and whether we feel at home at Coramdale. Our lives have all changed a lot from the time we were in sixth grade. Every new year, every new school year, brought new teachers, new friends, new challenges and struggles, and it often felt for us as though nothing was stable, as though the very ground was moving beneath our feet. But the one constant in all of that was Mrs. Bowen. She was our rock, the one familiar face we could count on from year to year, the one teacher who would spend the next 8 years getting to know us as individuals, not just as musicians. So, on behalf of all my fellow band students, past, present, and future, I would like to say thank you, Mrs. Bowen.
Hey, everybody. I'm Audrey Saladin. I am the Collin County band captain, and I would just like to say a few words to thank Mrs. Clements. She is truly one of the best band directors I've ever had. Every morning at 7:50 a.m., she is always there with a smile and with patience and grace, and she is always there to make sure we have our music and make sure that we are learning to glorify God with our music and with our actions and with our hearts, and I'm just so thankful for the lovely, godly influence that she has had on myself and on our band, and we are so thankful for everything she's done for us.
Because just saying thank you doesn't actually mean anything unless you get them something. We did put together a little gift basket for them. We got them a nice gift card to Perry Steakhouse so they can enjoy a night off, which they very much deserve. We also got them like a Google Smart Home speaker setup so they can listen to all our band music as much as they want to. And we did get them some Starbucks money too so they can stay caffeinated for the rest of the school year. So one more time, thank you, Mrs. Bowen and Mrs. Clements.
We can go ahead and have the seniors come on up. Can have a seat. Y'all can just stay up here. Here we are, seniors. I can't believe it. Unbelievable that you guys have been with me, a lot of you since fifth grade, and now you're graduating. It's just crazy. So, Connor, can you come and stand beside me? So, Mr. Connor,
You've been in band since eighth grade. Okay, so that's actually kind of late. But that's okay, because that's just when you came to CDA. So there you go. In fact, you were a beginner in eighth grade. I love your story of starting band a little later. One thing you mentioned to me is how you enjoyed learning with the younger students and encouraging them along the way. You mentioned that one of your favorite memories was from summer CDA band camp. This is where you got to connect, make friends, and then you were then inspired in your music. Music is definitely in your family. I believe that your dad is a trombonist and the mom plays flute. Is that right? Okay. And as a side note, they met in band and are still happily married. Hey, all right. It's always fun to have that bond with a family member. You have served as one of our band officers, Connor, this year and have shared some great devotions over the Book of Psalms. I love your heart for Christ. In life's ups and downs, I have watched you cling to truth in your faith in Christ. Whether you had a good day or a bad day, your consistency to ultimately serve God with your life is evident. You are a musician's musician. You can do it all. You're a singer, a guitarist, a trombone player, and a bass trombone player. I am sure that I've left out some instruments, most likely, but God has truly gifted you with the gift of music. I've so enjoyed watching you at the choir concert as you lead worship at the beginning, and also just watching you as you truly and honestly experience music as a singer and instrumentalist. I see Miss Miller over there. She knows what I'm talking about. It is obvious to me that you gain so much joy and fulfillment through music. I love that you are in worship band. Leading worship is for sure something you should do for the rest of your life. It is how God made you. He made you to be one of the Levites, one of his musicians. Connor, thank you for being there for the band program all these years. You've been dependable and reliable, and I could always count on you. I could always count on you knowing and learning your part and being there 100% for the team. You've done many ensembles over the past years, and you've also gone to state contests at least two of those years. Your contribution in band and jazz band as a bass trombonist will certainly be missed. Your tone and sound and musicality are so evident in every piece of music that you play. I see you as someone who values and really understands music. God is using and will definitely continue to use you if you allow him. I pray that you will be like Chenaniah, I hope I said that right, Mr. Oaks, from 1 Chronicles 15:22, who God appointed out in his word as a leader of the Levites in music and should direct music, for he understood it. Connor, you will be missed. All right, Alex Cannon. Okay, so Alex, first of all, I just want to let you know, I want to encourage you and let you know that you were the first senior to get back to me with an email answering all of my questions. What about that? Hey, all right. That's just a side note. I didn't say that for any particular reason, but you were first. You were first. So, Alex, you came to CDA and joined band in eighth grade, back when I was taller than you, actually. right away, I recognized your talent and was so happy to get another great percussionist. I could always count on you to learn your parts and be prepared with your music. In fact, you were in a percussion ensemble that qualified for state solo and ensemble contest for all 4 years in symphonic band. You've been a solid and dependable player in pep band the past 4 years as well. This was a priority for you. In all of your rhetoric school years, you rarely, if ever, missed any games. Did you miss any games? I don't know. I don't think so. Yeah. I could always count on you being there. Great job, by the way, on La La Land and the percussion ensemble. Very nice. When I asked you to share your thoughts about band and music over the years, one of the things that stood out to me in your response was the friendships that came out of this organization.
In your words, building friendships has been the most important part of the band, being together, working together, and depending on each other. Truth and Caroline looked out for me, got me out of a pinch or two, like when I forgot my music. What? You forgot your music? Oh, okay. And they always noticed when I needed something. Andrew, I guess that's Andrew Ferrier, and Ryan Moore and Ben Arnold also became great friends as well. I could and still do lean on the Ledbetters when things are hard. Seth and Ethan Vera, you guys are my guys. Alex, one cool thing about you is watching how you turn that around and have been encouragement and been an encouragement to newer symphonic band percussionists, especially with pep band. As far as fond memories go, you mentioned the football away games with just the percussion guys, which is a little scary to me that, because I was not on this trip, it was a lot of fun, I wasn't there, so especially when I wasn't there, not sure what that means, but. So you also mentioned that by far your favorite memory was the Disney trip. So Alex, we will miss you next year, and I want to send you out with this verse from our study in the book of Psalms. Psalm 9:18 says, "Rejoice in hope, be patient in tribulation, be constant in prayer. Keep the faith, keep encouraging those around you, and keep building on your foundation in Christ." We'll miss you. Give me a hug. Hey, Rachel, come on up. Rachel Irizarry. Look, not the only girl, because we got Collin County girls. We got Stuti over here, and we don't have Joanie. That's next year. Phew, we get you another year. That's a good thing. Rachel Irizarry, I am sad to have to say goodbye to my last Irizarry band member. You've been in band since fifth grade. I remember having you and your sister in my flute section. Besides being in band leadership, you have worked hard on the flute and accomplished much, including making all-region band 5 years and going to state solo and ensemble on a solo 1 year and in an ensemble for 4 years. I had so much fun reading about your band memories, like the time we went to Sandy Lake Band Festival. Does everybody remember Sandy Lake? Back when it was open and then they closed it because it got a little scary. Fortunately, all your children are here and alive. That's a good thing. But let's just say, Rachel, that you walked away from one of the rides wearing someone else's lunch. Right? Remember that? Mm-hmm. That's when you know you're a really good friend, right? Another memory that you mentioned was your first day of symphonic band when we picked, Mrs. Clements and I, picked the hardest 3-octave chromatic scale for you to play for your scale test. You had no idea how to play it, and you almost quit band on the first day. And I didn't know that till like 2 days ago when she sent this to me. That would have been so sad. If you would have quit, I may have quit too. So I'm glad you're still here. In your own words, Mrs. Bowen and Mrs. Clements have always encouraged me to stay in band and continue to work hard. They have continuously gone out of their way to get to know me and make me feel like I belonged in band. I love when I get to school in the mornings and see Mrs. Bowen sitting at the front desk, eager to greet me and ask me how I'm doing. It has encouraged me deeply to see a teacher not just teach, but take the time to get to know her students and go out of her way to see us succeed. Okay, now I'm about to cry. I loved being in band. There were so many experiences such as solo and ensemble, all regions, sight reading contest, playing in the nursing homes, playing for them, and then hearing their stories, playing at commencement, grammar school festivals, and playing at Disney. These are things I would never have experienced if I had not done band. I love how Mrs. Bowen always fostered a Christian atmosphere and always encouraged her students not to give up when it seemed impossible to play a certain piece. I'm sad that this chapter is coming to a close, but I couldn't have made it without the love and support of all my teachers, parents, grandparents, and classmates. I would like to give a shout out to Lauren Joseph for being my flute and volleyball buddy and always being there for me and band and pushing me to try new things. I'm going to miss seeing you, Lauren, blossom and grow up in front of my eyes from a shy, quiet girl to a sassy, what? Sassy, funny, determined young lady. I'm going to miss you, Lauren. Rachel, we are going to miss you. I'm going to miss our little lunchtime visits on Friday. That's kind of sad that that's going away. I am going to send you out now with this Bible verse that says, from Psalm 143:4, remember what God has done for you. Let his grace and mercy comfort you and remind you of his unfailing love. We will miss you. Mr. Ethan Kendall, come on up here. All right, Ethan Kendall, you have been in band since fifth grade, and think you have, and you've always been taller than me. I'm pretty sure about that. And thinking through memorable times, you mentioned the time that you blasted Billy Joel's Piano Man on the harmonica in the band closet. Just when I was about to start class. Obviously, this was back in your younger, less mature days, right, Ethan? Just reminding you of that part. So when asked about the importance of band and music in your life, here are some of the things you had to say. There should be more emphasis in the word family in band family. You become like a sibling among siblings with a mother who likely will always know better than you. This is true, by the way. And just like siblings in one family, you will move through ups and downs, lefts and rights. You may laugh, you may cry. Chances are you won't avoid being a little awkward or cliche. And as the themes of tonight would have it, saying goodbye is just as confusing as saying hello. However long you are in band, whether it be 2 years or eight, you enter not too expectant, and you leave not quite the same as you were before. As someone was often the youngest in whatever school group I'm in, there have been many people I've looked up to over the years, and I remember them fondly. Most of them were in band. This is for one simple reason. Band and being a family takes dedication to take care of it, and not just any dedication, but a compassionate one. I believe that this elective, more than any other class, is the greatest opportunity you will have at school to learn what it means to be humble, to be considerate of one another's wishes before your own. You will make unforgettable memories and even more unforgettable friends, friends that might even teach you not only to live for someone else, but to live in general. Ethan, you mentioned in your notes that you were concerned that you may not have contributed enough to our band family. But I'm here to tell you the opposite. You are my first trombone player with a range like no other. We would never have been able to play the difficult music that we played in both symphonic and jazz band without an amazing first trombone player. We all know, as your family, what you contributed musically. Besides your contribution in the symphonic and jazz band, you led many small ensembles to state solo and ensemble competition. In addition, you made us, as a band and as a school, proud when you made the All-State Jazz Band. Additionally, there is no way that we could have happily survived this year without your dedication to Thursday afternoon setup every week. You see, you fail to see your value in our family, but we all see it. Every day we see you in band class. The last thing you mentioned in your note to me was that you were truly grateful for the band family, and if it weren't obvious enough, you are not ready to leave. Well, we're not ready for you to leave either. You don't have to. And on that topic, please come back and bring your trombone to the games. Play with us in the pep band. I won't ever let myself... here we go. You ended your note saying, I won't let myself forget my time in band. And I'm going to say to you, Ethan, I will never forget you and your contribution to band. We will miss you more than you know. Ethan, you are valuable and you have contributed much, and I want you to always remember Psalm 139:14. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. We will miss you. Thank you for all your help all year with setup and as a first trombone player. Congratulations. David Browning, come on up. You are in trouble. All right, David Browning, you joined band in seventh grade. Your sister Elizabeth was already in the band, and she was serving every Thursday after school, setting up the band room. In a conversation that you and I had recently, you shared with me that you were actually setting up the band with your sister 1 to 2 years before you even joined the band. So before he joined the band, he was setting up the band room. That's amazing. You've become quite the musician and such a solid tuba player. Your commitment to music and the tuba led you to making all region 4 years and all state 2 years. You went to solo and ensemble contest 4 to 5 years, and you qualified at least 2 years advancing to state on a solo and or ensemble. You are one of the most positive persons I know. You always have a good attitude, and you are one of my biggest cheerleaders on days, especially this year, when I needed to be encouraged. When recalling his memories over the year in band, here's what David had to say. I will always remember the two guys I looked up to, Ben Kuykendall and Michael Perrone. My main reason for doing so was not because they were so talented, though they certainly were very talented. I looked up to them because they were kind to me, a newbie on the tuba, one who Mrs. Bowen challenged to join intermediate on his first year of band. I would have thought that they would see my world as small and insignificant, yet they inspired me to be more like them, and that they were leaders from behind, being humble but leading the band in what they did. Even when doing that, they had fun doing it. Seeing that they were able to do all of this inspired me to do the same. So when recalling how band and music has changed his life or outlook, here is what David had to say. Since I first joined band, I have greatly grown spiritually, emotionally, and musically. Spiritually, playing tuba specifically has taught me humility. Even though I might not have the melody or a catchy part, tuba, yeah, this is true, right? Tuba gives me the chance to be the foundation to those parts and support them to sound even better. Emotionally, band has become a family to me, one that I want to help out with, even if it may be behind the scenes. Musically, my skill has increased, as has my knowledge of music, which has in turn increased my appreciation for it. I'm very thankful to have been a part of this family and make music that glorifies God. And I see Mr. Tom Oakley back there, who is your mentor and private lesson teacher, and has done an amazing job with David. So we're glad to see you here to help honor David. Every teacher at CDA will back me up when I say this about David Browning. David has an incredible heart for service, right? All teachers, every day that I see this young man, I hear one of the following questions or statements from him. Is there anything else you need me to do today? I'm so excited. Now, this is a statement. I'm so excited for band class tomorrow. We share that every Thursday, don't we? How do you want me to set the band room up today? Thank you for letting me help you today. Who says that? David Browning does. Thank you for letting me help you today. Wow. I'm so excited for the concert. David, today is your day. I'm giving you a special one-time award called the Servant Leadership Band Award. And it is in this box over here. Ms. Clem, I think it's the one on top. Servant Leadership Award, one-time award to David Browning. Thank you for serving us and encouraging the whole band and me all of these years. Congratulations. So, I send you out with 1 Peter 4:10, which says, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. Thank you for your service.
Thank you.
All right. All right, David Brownen. Brendan Kofink, come on up. Okay, Brendan. How you doing? Okay, Brendan Kofink, you have been in band since fifth grade. I remember those early years. Braces was not your friend for about a year or so. You almost switched instruments. Yeah, you did switch instruments. But you weathered the storm, came back to trumpet, and here you are today playing with, by the way, the most amazing sound and such trumpet power, right? Whenever I'm working with a younger student, private lesson student, I'm trying to get them to play louder, I say to them, I need for you to channel your inner Brendan Kofink, because he's got so much power. He can play loud. We always need him. When he's not at the game, we all know it, right? One of my favorite memories of you as my trumpet student is playing trumpet duets with you over the years. You are an incredible sight reader. Really, really amazing. And that is a skill that has really served you well over the years and has been a huge asset for our concert and sight reading events over the years and whenever we get new music in class. Brendan, you made All-State Band for 4 years and would have been recognized this year at the All-State Clinic and Concert as being a 4-year All-State student, which is amazing. TPSMEA only has about 6 to 8 students each year that are recognized at this event for this honor. So congratulations, that is quite an accomplishment. In addition to this, you've gone to state solo and ensemble for at least 4 years on a solo and or ensemble. Here are some thoughts that you shared with me about band and music. Music has really changed how I see the world. Now everybody listen to this. Okay, ready? Music has really changed how I see the world. It's amazing to see the harmony every day around us. Music as a universal language helps us see from new perspectives and convey emotion without words. Wow, okay, so I'm going to most likely use this and in my next speech about the value of music. That's incredible. Concerning band memories, here's what you shared. My best memories are my friends from band. Music has created lasting friendships between me and my classmates, and I'll always remember all the fun we've had, whether at Disney or state or just in the band room. So I'm giving you a hard time, but it's true. I will miss looking over in the trumpet section and seeing smiles on whoever is sitting on either side of you throughout rehearsal. For a while now, it's been Lana on one side and Ethan on the other. Now, there's been a lot of nonsense going on back there, but we've had a lot of fun making great music and making sure that there is some serious choreography to go along with whatever piece we're doing, right? This is something that you have always taken ownership of, Brendan, just making sure we got the choreography going. And if there's any parts missing, no matter what the instrument, I can always count on you to jump in there and fill in the missing part. You are so talented, Brendan, and so musical, and have been such a huge asset to our band. When I think of you, I think of joy and music. And as a side, I have so enjoyed watching your shows in theater and laughing, Miss Colvin, like laughing until we all cry. He is so funny on stage. I hope you catch out the show, right, Cinderella, in a couple weeks or next week. That's next week, Miss Colvin. Brendan, you have brought us joy, and you bring us great music. I pray this for you from Nehemiah 8:10, that the joy of the Lord will always be your strength. We will miss you next year, and congratulations on receiving Outstanding Senior Award. All right, Ms. Clements, you want to come up and do one of yours?
I have two seniors at Collin County, and they know how much I love them because I tell them probably too often how much I love them, and I would pretty much adopt them. Y'all want to come be a part of my family? They're not sure. But I love them to pieces, and they know that I'm sincere in this. And so first I'm going to honor Stuti. Do you want to come stand with me? Stuti, seeing you graduate from the CDA band is bittersweet. I have been spoiled to having you in my symphonic band for the past couple of years, and I really just cannot put into words how much your presence and your dedication have meant to me and have meant to the program. Stuti reminded me when she sent me her memories that she has been in the CDA band for 2 years. That can't be right. That's what I think. That can't possibly be right, but it is. And so when you see her playing, it just seems like impossible that she started flute such a short time ago. One of my favorite things about Stuti, and I have 1,000, but I can't stay here all night and list all of them, Stuti is always in a good mood. And my Collin County friends can agree, right? She is always in a good mood. She never complains. I have never heard her complain about anything. And I know she's taking tough classes and she's busy. She's an athlete and she plays piano. She never complains about anything. And how many of us can say that we have that attribute? No one, but Stuti does. Having your constant and positive presence is like one of those extra long summer days where the sun doesn't set until 9 and we just stay outside playing. You guys remember those days as kids? That's what having Stuti in your band is like. She's the sunshine that I remember growing up as a kid, staying out. I didn't want the day to end, and that's my Stuti. Just don't want her to leave, but I have to let her. So I'll keep this short and sweet. This is not the only wonderful thing about you. You are a discerning and careful musician. You apply the same technical dedication and the same thought to flute as you have for many years on the piano, and also the same way that a person twice her age would approach the flute, again, with 2 years of flute experience. This year alone, you played in a woodwind trio that earned a first division, and you played a magnificent solo that earned the same recognition, a first division. Side note, Stuti shared with me that one of her favorite band memories is Friday nights, playing cowbell at the football game. If you think she's a great flute player, she plays a mean cowbell. And she said that she loved doing that because it was a nice, fun way to decompress and de-stress after a full week of school. And we did have fun. So she does know how to have fun, ladies and gentlemen. You have made every single Friday that I've known you a better day just by showing up and just by sharing yourself with us. You consistently work hard, and you have that kind of self-discipline that really can't be taught. And I think it will carry you through whatever you pursue, from music to schoolwork to internships in the future and ultimately your career. And I do believe that will be the career of Stuti's choice, whatever she wants to do. She has shared with me that one day you want to be a physician, and possibly, can I say the other part, the S, surgery, possibly a surgeon. And so I like to joke with Stuti that one day I might be on her table. So I have to be very nice to her. I think, have I been nice enough to her over the years? So if I ever am on her table, she'll be nice to me. And she won't forget to sew me back up. That's her promise. So my verse for you is Joshua 1:9, and it says, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." And I know you will go a lot of fantastic places, Stuti. So I hope you remember your band years at CDA with joy as you move forward, just as I will always remember my few short years with you. And I love you.
Okay, John Philip Sousa. The John Philip Sousa Award is a nationally recognized award that a high school band director may award to one of his students. It is restricted to one award per school per year, or two in the rare event of a tie. The award recognizes superior musicianship, dependability, loyalty, and cooperation. It recognizes superior musicianship and outstanding dedication. This award is given to the outstanding musician from a band organization. From Flower Mound, this is one of those rare events where we have a tie. Ethan Joseph and Owen Girth, can you guys come on up here? And let's do this. We'll start with Ethan and then you can come up next. But so congratulations to both of them. So Ms. Clements has your award. Ethan, you have been in band since fifth grade. Unbelievable that here you are standing as a senior, and I was taller than you. I remember you during those Logic school years. You were very quiet, but you were very serious about the trumpet. You worked hard, and even from those early middle school years, you were making some amazing music and auditioning for and making first-year trumpet, even in middle school. Your trumpet skills are quite remarkable and reflect some serious time in the practice room. The solos that you chose to play for solo and ensemble contest over the past 2 years have been impossible solos to most high schoolers. And frankly, the solo that you did this year is one that is not even in my library as a trumpet teacher, as a solo that I would even dream of giving to a high school student. You found this solo on your own and presented it to me as something that you really wanted to do. And I have to be honest and say that when I initially listened to the recording of this piece, I was doubtful that you should try to do this impossible solo your senior year, right? You want to go out your senior year feeling good about yourself. But you went behind my back and you ordered it and you learned it anyway. And then you came to your first lesson with that solo and quite literally blew me away. I mean, it was amazing. In the first lesson, it was not anything that I taught him. He took it home, owned it, and it was incredible. And on that note, you have taken a solo to state solo and ensemble contest for 5 years while still managing to go to state with small ensembles those same years. Here are some of your accomplishments, or some more of your accomplishments. You auditioned and made the TPSMEA All-State Band for the past 5 years. Making All-State High School Band beginning in eighth grade. You auditioned and placed first chair in the band this year. In fact, this was your second time to earn first chair. Though they were not able to have the event because of COVID, there are generally only 1 to 3 students that are recognized as 5-year students. So congratulations on this amazing accomplishment, Ethan. That's fantastic. This last year, you auditioned and made the Lone Star Wind Orchestra, an audition-only group made up of young musicians, public and private school, all over the DFW area. This was a huge honor. To have a conversation with you, Ethan, one might never know that you had received so many honors. In fact, when asked about your thoughts on the difference band or music has made in your life, you said, "I think band is like collaborative art. We have to all work together to turn sheet music into actual sound. Solos are fun, but I think the best and most moving music is ensemble pieces." Your desire to bring people together through music was evident during COVID when you wrote that arrangement for the trumpet ensemble of, William Tell Overture? Yeah, for the Flipgrid project, which was awesome. Some of your favorite band memories are from Disney and Allstate, especially eighth grade when you had Dr. Delaney as your conductor. Ethan, we will miss your amazing trumpet sounds and those fantastic high notes that only you can play. I will personally miss your smile when something musically fantastic happens in the classroom or when Brendan does something ridiculous that you can't help but laugh at. I pray that you will always find joy in music as you remember this verse, 1 Peter 4:10, which says, "Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms." Congratulations on John Philip Sousa. Girth. All right. Owen Girth, all that hair. Oh my goodness. All right. Isn't there a rule against this, Mr. Oaks? Owen Girth, you have been in CDA band for 7 years. You are currently our band captain, and you blow us away with your amazing saxophone playing on a regular basis. You are one of the most, if not the most, outstanding jazz musician that CDA has ever had. Beyond just being a great player, you are an extremely hard worker. You've put hours and hours of practice time on those saxophones of yours, tenor saxophone, alto saxophone, and now the soprano saxophone. The judge at our most recent solo and ensemble contest was speechless after your solo, literally. He was so impressed with your skill and ability on the saxophone. I happened to walk into the room after his solo, and he was just kind of going, "What just happened?" So anyway, there you go. I don't know if I told you that or not. Now you know. Don't get too arrogant. Bring it down. Yeah, bring it down. Owen, you have made Allstate for the past 3 years with 5 actual selections between the concert and jazz band and the alto and tenor saxophone. You received the honor of making first alto in the jazz band one of those years. Additionally, you auditioned and were selected for a prestigious 17-member jazz ensemble, the Greater Dallas Youth Jazz Orchestra. You have played with that group for the past 2 years. You have also played Class 1 solos and ensembles for the past 5 years, advancing to state and receiving a superior rating every year. Your attributes go beyond talent and ability. You're a hard worker in not only achieving your own personal goals, but also the goals of our band organization. You have effectively led our band this year in so many ways. You are organized. You make sure everything is in order. Coach Riley and I actually were just recently talking about you and how you took ownership of the football and the band schedule, which, by the way, he played football this year for the first year ever in his life. Like your life, maybe? Ish? Okay, sort of. So Owen consulted with the coach and worked out an alternating schedule which divided the players so that both band and football players could continue to have effective practices. Being this proactive and organized is a remarkable skill that will take you far in life. Besides being organized, Owen, you are an encourager. I saw this day after day in the band hall with our young musicians, and especially in the jazz band rehearsal where we were all experimenting and trying out new kinds of improvisation. But no matter what came out of our horns, you encouraged everyone. Besides being an encourager, you inspire. You are a master at the art of improvisation, and your example led us as an ensemble to grow in our jazz music. Besides being an inspiration, you have a servant's heart. You have volunteered as a classroom helper for 2 years in our Logic School bands. Is it 2 or 3? 2. Okay. No, not too much credit. All right. You also are one of the last ones to leave the band classroom as you make sure everything is put away and nothing is left for Mrs. Clements and I to clean up. Much appreciated. When asked about music and band and its impact on you, you said, "Band has been the place where I've made many of my closest friends and become connected to students in other grades. There are several former band students who I still talk to frequently, despite the fact that they now attend colleges halfway across the country. Band has supplied me with rich memories and deep friendships that will last a lifetime." Owen, you have filled our band room with joy and life. You make coming to band class a blast for everyone. I will miss seeing you light up a concert hall with your jazz saxophone solos. Owen, continue to allow Christ to do his work in you. Philippians 1:6, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to the completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Congratulations on John Philip Sousa Award. And finally,
Tim, can you join me? You guys, it's been a long night, and I want to tell you it's such a pleasure for me to be able to round this special time out. with our final senior, and that's Timothy Lee. Thank you. I would like to say Tim didn't share a band memory with me, so I have total freedom to insert any loving memory starring Mrs. Clements and the band at large, insert memory here. But I have so many good things to say with Tim. What a year it has been, Tim, and what a blessing you have been to our band at large and to me in general. In a year of unpredictability, you have really been our rock. I think we would all agree. You have been our rock. You have been, for me, somewhat of a permanent fixture in nearly all of my band days at CDA. And I say that because there was one year where you were attending another school. One. And then he came, and I always knew there was this third Lee child. If you know the other ones here, one has graduated, and I knew there was a third Lee, and they told me, Tim is quite different than Paul and Joanna. And I was like, I cannot wait to meet Tim. And I treasure Tim, and he knows that. I'm not exaggerating when I say this, there are band directors who would go to great lengths, like great, great lengths to get a person who sounds like you on the euphonium. You wouldn't know it in our band room at CDA because we've kind of always had Tim, and I have these two other amazing, currently low brass trombone players. So you wouldn't know it, but they're really hard to come by. You wouldn't know it by listening to our bands here. But for whatever reason, God in his abundance has blessed me with that great joy, so I get to be Tim's teacher, and it's been so fun. It has been so fun getting to know you and to watch your talent grow through the past few years. And we have had good years, we've had bad years. We are having a COVID year right now, which I'm challenging myself to say is not a bad year for us, and that's a blessing, right? And Tim and I were having that conversation the other day in our first period band about how it has, on paper, been such a strange year, but such a good year to us. So Tim's been there with me for everything in between. And this is where I'm gonna joke that although Tim didn't provide a memory, I know Tim loves band. Tim's whole family is probably just one of the backbones of support in our band program at Collin County. And I know that Tim loves band because, was it 2 years ago? These two beautiful students did not even get to come to band every Friday. And band is already only a 1 day a week class, but there was a conflict in the schedule with a lab. And so Tim, I got to see once every 9 weeks or something crazy. And how many times did I go to Mrs. Bowen, you don't know this, and I said, there's no way they're gonna stay, they're gonna quit. It's just too much work. They don't even get to be in class. They're gonna quit. But they didn't. And that's a testament to Tim as a person, to his dedication and his love of music. And I am so glad that you didn't quit. I would have cried if she had quit too. And he made Allstate that year, yes. There, we could stop there, right? But we won't. Seeing you excel, Tim, has been not only in that year, but now this year, with its many challenges. It has been so inspiring, and I pray that you always maintain an attitude of joy, of flexibility, no matter what you face in this life, and this year has been great training for us in that regard. And I pray that you always have a willingness to be molded and shaped by our Creator. Tim, you and I have a lot of things in common. It probably doesn't seem like it. But I see a lot of myself in Tim. Tim has a sense of humor, but it's veiled because he knows when to be serious. Tim, you are careful in your actions. You're careful as a player, and you're persevering in your dedication to doing a job well. Sometimes you, like me, are critical of yourself if something doesn't go just right. For example, like missing a note or two. And when we care a lot, the stakes feel very high. And sometimes, I know for me, and I believe for you, we kind of get into our own heads. That being said, I have seen you pull through those times and play beautifully in the craziest of circumstances. And on that note, I do also pray that you always continue to enjoy the gifts given to you, the gift of music. Somehow, continue to cultivate and shape and enjoy your gifts because they are from the Lord and they are good. And I, on behalf of our whole band, I will certainly miss your big, beautiful, larger-than-life sound. And so, Tim, in conclusion, and families in conclusion, this is my verse for Tim. This is Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10, and it says, For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. And so, Tim, I hope that you rest in the fact that God rendered you like an artist would render a masterpiece. And he created you for good works that you may not know right now, and I may not know, but he does know the plan, and he knows the extent of those good works. And so we'll miss you so much, Tim. It has been so fantastic having you in the CDA band. An awkward pause. I would like to, Mrs. Bowen's gonna grab something. I would like to award you the John Philip Sousa Award from Collin County.
Thank you for staying and being a part of this presentation. This is such a special time. Mrs. Clements and I have these students from fifth grade to 12th grade for the most part, and they're family, they're our children, and they just mean so much to us if they last to the 12th grade. So thank you for being patient and doing this with us, especially this year, this crazy, crazy year where our bells were covered and we were wearing masks, and it was a challenge, but everybody really persevered and did a great job. You wanna close this up? What's going on here?
Well, let me tell you. I wanted to present the first ever Mickey Mouse Award. No, I didn't, not at all. Actually, it is, as the older I get, the earlier my bedtime gets, so it is my bedtime. So this is a Mickey and Minnie. Can I take them? No, just kidding. Actually, in December, you heard tonight, there were several of our seniors that were talking about the Disney trip. So God willing, you know, and all of the natural catastrophes we've been walking through, God willing, December, we're going to Disney. So yay, next spring. Thank you very much. Oh boy. Gonna get fired from this job. Okay. All right. Next spring. Thank you, Mrs. Bowen. And so we will have fundraising opportunities even tonight. As you're leaving, there's an opportunity to give towards that. But on a serious note, I can't be too serious with these things in my arms. But it was really neat to hear their experience, just the highlight of much of their time here in the band, besides our wonderful band directors and the camaraderie, is seeing all that come together at the Disney trip. So not December, but next spring, plan on that. And again, any donations you give will help go towards that trip. A couple other announcements. Sunfire Studios has put together the recording tonight, and so you will have an opportunity to purchase that. You will also have an opportunity to purchase the pictures from Life Touch. So thank you guys from Life Touch being here tonight so patiently. Yes, thumbs up to you. My friends, the dynamic duo of the Millers, yes, are very talented choir family. It's like the Von Trapp family at Coramdale. Mr. Glenn Miller is our choir director in Collin County, and Mrs. Sharon Miller, the choir director in Flower Mound. You guys ought to, well, you already are. So on Thursday, the day after tomorrow, we're gonna have another concert here at 7:00. So be sure to come for that. And I think, I just noticed something. Where is Mrs. Dwyer?
I'm here.
And this is your reminder to not forget about Cinderella next week. Our students are fabulous. Yes, of course, Cinderella. Ooh. You don't want to miss that. So, don't miss it. Also, don't forget to wear your masks and your crown if you happen to bring yours as you leave. Pick up your trash and any glass slipper that you see upon exiting. I'm missing mine. Let's leave this place shining. And seniors and parents of seniors, there's a reception outside on the gazebo just for you. And don't forget to make a very generous donation. After a year of COVID, these kids need to go to Disney World.
And let's call it a night. Well done.